Hey everybody, Dutch Sense here. 4:38 p.m. Central Time on Friday, April 27th, 2012. And we're over here on my video I just released. I'm going to take you down and we're going to read a few comments that were left by a couple of my viewers. They're from Debo515013. If time allows you, Dutch, it would be great to get a radiation test after the fresh rain. And I said, yes, I will do that. And the reason they're asking me to do that is because of what's going on over in Japan right now. Now, Fukushima, of course, from last year, still ongoing, still releasing radioactive particulate matter, supposedly, and ambient particulate matter, just from exploded rods that are laying out in the open. And this happened 5 days ago. A depleted uranium factory in Japan exploded completely, and we'll just go ahead and show you. Let this video load. Alright, there it is. Alright, I'm not going to show you the whole thing. I'll put a link down below for this. But 3,400 containers exploded. That was 5 days ago, roughly 6 days ago. That released a huge cloud into the air. Massive cloud. Here's the video of it. Here it is burning. And that, of course, goes right over the ocean and comes out across the Pacific towards us. So, here is Japan, where my mouse is up here. Let me slow this down so you can see what's going on. Okay, so let me just stop it and we'll bring it back. And we'll bring it back to the first frame. Alright, this is starting roughly on the 22nd. Alright, so we're going to bring it forward from the 22nd until the last frame, and you can see basically, again, Japan is right here where my mouse is, where this big cloud is over the area on the 22nd. So you can watch that cloud and roughly understand where the plume is in relation over the last 5 days. So you can just keep track of this area here, somewhere in this region, and this is what is coming our way with a big cloud of depleted uranium. Okay, I'm just bringing it forward one frame at a time. Okay, now you see the cloud is actually evaporating off, so it's going to become harder to track, but you can see it's roughly right here still. Keep coming forward. That's bringing it to Hawaii, south into the southern arm of this next coming storm, somewhere in this region right here. Okay, now let's just keep bringing it forward. No one else is tracking this, by the way, guys. I'm the only one that I know that is doing this. Now, why am I worried? Well, because depleted uranium put into a particulate matter that's put up into the air column will come to the United States across Hawaii and to the West Coast and will fall in particulate matter form in the precipitation in some form. Now, they'll probably tell you it's not enough to cause any kind of alarm because of the area that it's traveling across and the amount of precipitation, etc. However, I would like to point out there is no good amount of radiation. No one's talking about this. You see where the storm is going. It's going towards Hawaii, and then it's going to come towards the West Coast. Will it set off sensors and alarms? I do not know. Will it have any effect? I do not know. All I'm here to tell you is that Japan is here. A big cloud of depleted uranium just blew up 5 days ago and has gone up into the air column. How far? We don't know. How far will travel? We don't know. It's best to know that this occurred, so that's why I'm putting this out right now. I don't want you to panic. I don't want you to freak out. All I want you to do is know that this happened, okay? So there's system cleansers, there's different things you guys can do. I don't know what to recommend to protect yourself from particulate matter of uranium, depleted uranium. There's no knowing how small the particles will be. And I would just say, just to be safe, in this coming storm, the precipitation that falls in this would be something you might want to be aware of. Cheers, folks. I hope you have a good day and hang in there.